Hi everybody, we continue with Tikkuni HaZohar. We are in verse Lamed Zayin 37 from the Sulam and from the Tikkuni HaZohar of Matok Midvash. We are in page Resh Yud Bet of Matok Midvash, okay, second section. So we're talking about the Shva. Remember, we continue talking about the Nekudot. Nekudot means the vowel below the letter. Every Nekuda, every vowel is not just the sound of the words. As a meaning, I mean, why the shape is the way it is. It's not like English when you have I and E and A or O, which is the vowel. Here we are talking more about, you know, there is value to those nekudot, those vowels. The Hebrew language are weakening the Hebrew letters. Without those vowels, the Hebrew letters would not have any value. So just think about it from that point of view, it's tremendous understanding. And for that reason, we have to adapt this understanding and grow from that as we study Tikkuni HaZohar, for being Tikkuni HaZohar, bringing us to a new language, a new understanding, a new concept. So I'm going to read first what Rav Brandwein have to say about it, and then we jump in and out to see if there is a completion in Matok Midvash. So I will read first the Tikkuni HaZohar in Aramaic from the Tikkuni HaZohar itself. Shva, mind you, kasher yeh ofan betoch ha'afan, ואינון את המאור הגדול ואת המאור הקטון ואינון גוף וברית ולקבלו חמה ולבנה דינו לקבל אימא אלה ודתה. So if we look from תיקוני הזוהר, תיקוני הזוהר is give us the short message, talk about the שווה. Those of you don't recognize the שווה, there is basically two dot. You know, you have צרה, it's also two dot, but צרה is going horizontal. When שווה is going one above, one below. So you need to know the shape first. That's called Shva. That's the Nekudot. Mayin hu, kasher yeh ofan betoch ha'ofan. When something inside of something, or system inside of system, that's Tikkuni HaZohar said, v'inun et ha'maor, what does that mean? The great light in heaven, and the small light in heaven, meaning related to the sun and the moon. And as you study with me for a while, related to Malchut and Zeher Anpin, Vinin guf bebrit is like the body and the organ, the sexual organ of a man. It's called brit. Ulekableu chamal levana, or chamal levana, sun and the moon. Dinu lekabel ima ila avedata, is to receive the mother above and the mother below, meaning bina and malchut. This is short explanation of the Tikkuni HaZohar. Now we have to get and to really understand what's going on here. Shoel. First, we need to understand that section is a shela, it's a question. Ma'u sod bet ha'nekudot shel shva? What is the secret of that concept called shva, that vowel in under the Hebrew letter that called shva? Remember, vertical from above and one below. Umeshiv, the answer is shu sod ha'katuv kaisher yeh ha'ofan betoch ha'ofan. It is something that came from Ezekiel, those of you who know Ezekiel, that something inside something, a system inside a system. Meaning what? Kenekuda usod malchut. Every time we see one dot as the nekuda, whatever it is, chirik, or one dot is related to malchut, because dot means malchut. Excuse me. Ve'ofan usod malchut. So when we say the system inside the system, but the word we're using is ofan, like ofan mean a wheel. And the way you say bicycle in Hebrew, you say ofanaim. And the reason you say ofanaim is because there is two wheel. That's why you say ofanaim, two wheel. So ofan mean one wheel. So when you say ofan, or you say nekuda, you say one dot, it's both mean malchut. Ukevan, shemalchut alta minitmatka bebina. When we know what happened in Tzimtzum Bet, Malchut went up to Bina to sweep the Malchut. Why did Malchut need to be sweet? Because Malchut is dinim, it's judgment. So we need to sweep it in other female. What is the other female in the system we use Kevavke? Bina. Ukevan Malchut al tavin itbarka bina. Neshav Malchut lebet ofanim. So because Malchut went and became sweet in Bina, it became two ofanim. It became two wheel. Two system. וכן לבית נקודות, it become also two נקודות, two dot. זו תחת זו, one under another, כמו שווה. like the vowels of Shva. So now you know Shva is a system that represents the whole concept of two malchuyot, one above another. והם את המאור הגדול שמקבלת מבינה, המתלבשת בזרנפין, the light and מלכות receiving from בינה has to go now to זרנפין, no longer coming direct. Remember, we studied it many times, that what happened to unite the two systems together, we have to lower the left column. The left column represented by מלכות, represented by the לבנה. On Wednesday, when God created the sun and the moon, God said to the moon, לכי ומעתי את עצמך, go make yourself smaller. מה זה מעטי, makes it smaller, meaning small, make sure the gimel הראשון, the kedar chokma bina, of the left column going down. ואת המאור הקטן, היינו מלכות, והם גוף שעושות תפארת זעיר אנפין, וברית שעושות יסוד. So, they united, when that system happened, והם גוף, and they are body, שעושות תפארת. What is the secret of the body from a ספירות point of view? Tiferet, or you can call it Ze'er Anpin, because Tiferet called Ze'er Anpin as well. Ubrit, what is the secret of the Brit? The circumcision area is what is called Brit. What do we call it? Yesod. It's the ninth Sfira, Yesod. Shehu Michaze V'Lemata. And we know we have two systems, one Michaze V'Lemala, and one Michaze V'Lemata. The one Michaze V'Lemala, okay, this is bo rachamim, mi chazev lemata, dinim, from the chest up, mercy, chest down, judgment, rachel, lea, those of you who know that, v'kol mi chazev lemata, shach l'malchut. So everything from the upper chest and down is belong to malchut, belong to judgment. Obchinot, kshenegdam, em chama v'levana. And corresponding to that is the sun and the moon. Shem Ze'er Anpin u'malchut, which is Ze'er Anpin and Malchut. Shem neged ima ila'a, המתלבשת בתוך Ze'er Anpin נקראת חמה, ואימא תתה היינו מלכות. So, what is the light of the sun? Is basically the light of Bina dressed by Ze'er Anpin. That's called חמה. That's what חמה. If you want to know what the sun is, what is the sun? It's basically a light that been dressed, coded by Ze'er Anpin. That's a word, it was coded by Ze'er Anpin, but the essence of the light is coming from Bina. V'ima tata'a, ayinu malchut. And the lower mother called malchut. So now we know what Shva is. Shva is the two system of basically above and below. So that's why you have two dot. The system of above, chazev elemala, and chazev elemata. Vesod ha-katuv, v'hineh ofan echad ba'aretz etzel ha-chayot. And we continue reading from Ezekiel. And one wheel is among the creature, etzel ha-chayot, or among the animal. But you can read it in a different way. Chayut. Chayut mean livelihood. And chayim, livelihood mean chokhmah. So let's see. זוהי הנקודה תחת הסגול, כלומר נקודה התחתונה שבסגול. So now, if you take שווה is two dot. If you add one dot to the שווה, what do you get? סגול. סגול is the three dot. So what is the lower dot within סגול? הרומז את הקו אמצעי אצל החיות, שהן בית נקודות של צרה. So here, it's beautiful. שווה is one and above. Segol is tzere with one dot. So it's different, okay? So again, there's no connection between Shva and Segol like I said before, because Shva is going one on top of each other. But if you take tzere, which is horizontal, two dot horizontal, which those of you know about Nekudot, Kamatz belong to Keter, Patach belong to Chochma, and Tzere belong to Bina. Very good. Shva belong to Gvura. Segol belong to Chesed. So what is the connection between Tzere, which is Bina, to Segol, that is Chesed? So it's telling us like this. הנקודה תחת הסגול, כלומר הנקודה התחתונה שבסגול לא רובזת על קו האמצעי, אצל החיות שהן בית נקודות של צרה. If you take the bet nekudot atzire, horizontal, remember, vertical is שבע. Horizontal, it's tzire, נקראות חיות על שם אור החוכמה. The reason we call it animals, okay, or creature, because it comes from the word חיות. חיות means livelihood, it's corresponding to חוכמה. שנקרא אור החיה, because the light that shine within חוכמה, is חיה, like the light that shine within, כתר, is יחידה. So every time we use the word חיה, we corresponding that to חוכמה. כמו שנאמר, חוכמה תחיה את בעליה, or another verse that say, that the wisdom will resurrect her owner of the wisdom. So from here, תחיה וחוכמה is corresponding to each other. So we understand, whenever we have the word חי, so we get to חוכמה. ועושות הכתוב ויעץ אלוקים את שני המאורות הגדולים שעומדים בקומה שווה ומתחלקים לימין ושמאל. And that's connected to the verse that God created the two shining force in heaven corresponding to the sun and the moon that they are equal. That's before the Tzimtzum, they were equal לימין ושמאל. So what is סגול? וכן הוא הסגול. סגול בתוך האופנים. What is סגול? Is one dot between two forces. You have right, you have left, and in between you have segol. שהם הנקודות של המלכות שורוק של גימל נקודות, כמו שנזר בזוהר חדש שיר השירים, סגול התהפך ונדרין בנקודה אחרה והוא שורוק דלת נקודים. What is the connection between שורוק, it look like קובוץ, it's like the three dots, and segol, because both of them have three dots. One of them have three data. If you have three data, it's three system. So what is the connection between Segol and Shuruk? Tell us Zohar Shir HaShirim, וסגול התהפך והתנהיר בדיוקנה אחריו שהוא שורוק. It says, Segol change face and become Shuruk. But what does that mean? אופן אחד, היינו נקודה למעלה, זה הנקודה הימנית שבסגול, הרומזת לכתר, חוכמה. You have three data, right? The right one, the one who stand on the right, it's keter chokma. ואופן אחד למטה, דענו נקודה שבסגול הרומזת לבינה תפארת מלכות. One dot below the right one, in the middle, this represent בינה תפארת מלכות. Remember, after the צמצום בית, when מלכות went up to בינה, so מלכות created a new ending. So keter chokma become one unit, and then everything below that become בינה, זרע פינה מלכות become one unit. והוא עמוד אמצעי ביניהם. אנו נקודה אמצעית מזער אנפין שעלה למים נוגבים לבינה והכריעה בין הקווים. So, the dot in the middle elevate the light, it's called מים נוגבים, female water. You know, every time that you are doing מצוות לא תעשה, every time you're doing, you're preventing yourself from doing something negative, you're doing מים נוגבים. Those מים נוגבים is the נקודה אמצעית, is the middle point. מזער אנפין, it's coming from זער אנפין, שעלה למים נוגבים לבינה, that it's become female water to בינה, והכריע בין הקווים, and it created the two forces will be united. ובשורוק, ובסוף הנקודות. In שורוק, you see one, two, and three, that's the shape, so the dot is in the bottom. In סגול, the dot is in the middle, you consider it as in the middle. It's maybe in the bottom, but it is in the middle. והוא סוד, והנה אופן אחד בארץ, שזה חיריק, שהוא למטה. So when you talk about אופן, we talk about that wheel, that below, you talk about חיריק. חיריק is one dot below the letter. כל ניצוץ הוא יוד, שהנה נקודה, והוא סוד חוכמה. So every time we see a נקודה, one dot, is a nitzot, it's a spark, which is like the letter yud. So every time you, let's say you want to do gematria, you want to do calculation of the nekudot as well, every time you have one dot, it's 10 points like the letter yud. For that reason we call it yud. שהיא נקודה ועושות חוכמה. What is yud? חוכמה, yud כבפקה, חוכמה. ועושות מלכות, וכל רקיע עושות וו, ועושות חסדים, ועושות זער אנפין. And for that reason, I'm bringing בתוק מדבש, I don't feel that it was super clear. אופן אחד הוא היסוד, העומד אצל המלכות הנקראת ארץ. אצל החיות. ביסוד עומד אצל הנצח ועוד הנקראים חיות. בדוק מנבש אקספלן, those animals, those creatures are הנצח ועוד. Because you have one on the right, one on the left, it's the נצח ועוד. The one in the middle is the יסוד. So הוא עומד אצל החיות. הוא מפרש שהאופן הוא היסוד. So when we talk about the wheel, we talk about the יסוד. דיינו נקודה תחת סגול, שהוא נקודה דלתתה של הסגול. And this נקודה, this dot of the סגול below, it's the יסוד. והוא אצל החיות דהיינו צרה. Where is that יסוד? It's within צרה, because I told you, צרה look one dot in the right, one dot in the left. ונקודה של הסגול משווה עם נצח ועוד. So this is the נצח ועוד. מבחינת את שני המאורות הגדולים. And this is שני המאורות הגדולים. So when you look at צרה, you look at שני המאורות הגדולים, these two great light in heaven, which are in the sun and the moon, שהם שווים. Before the צמצום, they were equal. באופן שהנצח ועוד יסוד הם סוד נקודת הסגול. When you look at סגול, is נצח עוד יסוד, והעניין כנודע שלעולם הנצח עוד יסוד של פרצוף עליון נעשים מוכין לצומת תחתון ממנו. And we know that נהי, נצח עוד יסוד of the upper system is becoming what? נעשים מוכין. It become the light to the system below that. And the same thing is the רנפין. בדוח האופנים בצורת נקודת השירוק. If we take שירוק, שירוק by the way, שירוק mean the dot like in the middle of the letter. So for that reason, מתוק מדבש say, דיינו גימל נקודות הנקראות קובוץ. So you say, sometimes they call it שירוק, נקודה זר, sometimes they call it קובוץ. But in this sense, tell us מתוק מדבש, they relate to קובוץ. Meaning the three dots below the letter. הרומזת על dot different יסוד. Tell us מתוק מדבש, this is the חידוש that I was looking for. That the קובוץ, or the שירוק as they call it here, is related to the middle system of the all spherot. What's in the middle in the upper level? Da'at, right? You have Keter, but that's not considered sphera. But when you talk about Chokhmah Binah, Da'at, middle. What's the next one below? Tiferet, very good. What's the next one below? Yesod. So how many Da'at you have in Kubutz? 1, 2, 3. Da'at, Tiferet, Yesod. זה רנפין כזה, אופן אחד לאלר, דיינו למעלה מן התפארת והוא הדעת, ואופן אחד לדעתה תחת התפארת והוא היסוד. ויהיו עמודה את האמצעיתה בנהו, הוא התפארת, שבין הדעת והיסוד. So, in קובוץ, the above is the דעת, the below is the יסוד, and in the middle is the chest, which is תפארת. והעניין הוא, שהיסוד יכול לעלות עד הדעת, להמשיך הטיפה הקדושה דרך התפארת. We know, those of you studied Rabbi Chaim Vital, the Ari, the Etz Chaim, we know that the tipa, the sperm, you know, when people make children, start with the mind, with the consciousness, then it's going through the spine, and it's going through the neck, then the spine going all the way down till the delivery of the physical sperm. It's called Lamshich HaTipa HaKdoshah Derech HaTiferet. So the Da'at is basically activating that drop of sperm going through Tiferet to Yesod. וכשהיסוד לבדו ואינו ממשיך מן הדעת, אלא מה שיש בו נותן למלכות, על זה רומז משל כן, בני אופן אחד בארץ. היסוד משפיע על המלכות, דחיריק. When there is no system of השפעה, there's nothing really going on, then you have חיריק. You have only one dot below the letter. לטטה. אז הוא בחינת נקודה אחת, דחיריק, העומדת לבדה למטה, תחת האות. So when you see חיריק under the letter, there's no system, there's no השפעה. This is just one thing. ואומר כלל לכל הנזכר לאל, כל ניצוץ יהיו יוד, like we say before, every spark is the letter יוד, which is look like יוד, because it's small, which is מלכות. כל הנקודות הם סוד יודים. So every time you see a נקודות, let's say, what is קובוץ in גימטריה? 30. Because how many dots you have? 1, 2, 3. What is סגול in גימטריה? 30. Okay? So you have to look at it as, like this, בעזרת השם. וכל רקיע, וו, תן נקודת הפתח, וראש, הקמץ, הם סוד ווין, והוא סוד התפשטות הרקיע. So when you look at פתח, פתח, what is the difference in the נקודות? You ever thought about it? If you know Hebrew. Think about it. You have two types of nekudot, two types of vowels under the letter, or above the letter. You either have dat, or you either have vav. Did you ever thought about it? You have yud and vav. Then all the nekudot is chirik, cholam, it's only one dat. Only one dat. Even shuruk, it's one dat inside the letter. Kubutz is three dat. Segol is three. So what do you have not at that? Patach and the line above the nekuda of kamatz. And this is considered what? Zer anpin, consider vav. וראש הקמץ הם פסות ווין. So, וכל רקיע, וו, דיינו נקודת הפתח. When you look at פתח, what does פתח look like? וו, right? וו is פתח. נקודה below that, נקד קמץ. So, וו with נקודה become קמץ. I hope you're excited about it, because I am. It's important. Now, when you take the יוד כווו כה, the תיקוני הזוהר said, if you take יוד כווו כה, that is שווה, חולם, and קמץ. And שווה, two dot, one below each other, cholam, one dot above, kamatz, below, with line and a dot, shva yu dina, what is shva, say tikkun hazor, judgment, because it's gvura, kamatz rachme, kamatz is keter rachme, shmola v'yimina, so you have left and right, debitaman or right, I tev deua umadat v'tzeda, when the Torah is the center column, ובזמנה דינו לשווה כמץ חולם, הוא עמוס כי בי חשק ואפלתהו, רק במותך חשק השם. So there is a פסוק that say that בי חשק, that God wanting or desire me, or the other פסוק said, only in your father's God desire. So we need to explain it. יוד כווקה, בנקודת שווה חולם כמץ. When they have יוד כווקה, when the yud is in shva, the a is in cholam, and the vav is the kamatz. Shezehu nekudat shem havaya b'torah. When you look at the Torah, if you will need to put out to read the name of God, this is how you need to read it. In your mind, when you look at the name of God, yud kevavke, you have to read it like this. Yud b'shva, a b'cholam, vav b'kamatz. וזהו ניקוד של מילת לעולם. Where do we find that word with the right ניקוד? When we say forever. When you use the word forever, the למד is in שווה, the וו is in חולם, and the second למד is in קמץ. הוא מפרש הטעם, שהנקודות, השם מתחילות בנקודות שווה. יהודינה, so the way the name of God starts with שווה, which is דינים, שהיא נקודת הגבורה. קמץ שתחת הוו, רחמה. When you see the yud k vav as a kamatz. Yes, I'm gonna make sure I'm saying it to you correctly. Yeah, which is vav is in kamatz. Shebitachad vav rachme shenikudat chesed. It's wrote in here in matok midrash from the gra lifamim. It says sometimes kamatz is mercy. Okay, sometimes. So when you say sometimes, because it says "smolot tachat leroshi v'yiminot tachapkeni," his left arm under my head, and then his right hand hugging me. So you use the word lifamim sometimes. Dainu smolat chila v'chakach yimina. What he's trying to tell you is, if you look at the yud kevavke, so the yud kevavke start with shva, and then in the end of the yud kevavke you have kamatz yiminot tachapkeni. The Madonna and Breshden Bakavitsay Shulukat Cholam. What's between them? What's between them? Cholam. Cholam is it between them. The A is in Cholam. So if you have to read it, if I put Kuf there, it will be Yokova. That's how you read it. But if you read it with A, you understand how to read it. All right, I have to do Zadda, Zadda. What make the Yud Kevavke in balance, in mercy? Aynu Betiferet. הכלול החסד, החסדים והגבורות, so חולם is תפארת, and it's combined חסדים and גבורות, first גבורות and חסדים, הוא בא לראות שהתורה בדין ניתנה לישראל, and it's telling us that the Torah was giving us with judgment, that's what there is שווה first, וכן שם הוויה שהוא רחמים, מורר הדין תחילה, so a lot of time people think יוד כווקה is mercy, no, first is there is שווה, so there is always first דינים, לכן הוא בנקודת בשווה תחילה, to tell us when you see שווה in the beginning of the name of God, it's showing you there is judgment, ובזמנה נהנון, וכן שהשם בנקודות בנקודות שווה, כמה תחולם של נקודות של צבאות. When you see the word השם צבאות, צבאות is צדיק בשווה, בית בקמץ, אין וו בחולם. יורא בשתי אופני הנקודות ברזום במה שכתוב, כי בי חשק ואפלתהו, וכן מה שכתוב והרמתו חשק השם. שחשק ראשי תבות חולם. If, I'm sorry, שחולם שווה קמץ, הוא ניסה חשק. God will desire you. חשק. You have חשק. You have desire. You have lust to connect to the creator. But what does חשק mean? חולם שווה וקמץ. It's initial. The word חשק is initial. שהם נקודות חגת. חגת. בגימל אותיות השם הוויה. So you have חסד, גבורה תפארת. The חסד is the קמץ, the גבורה is the שווה, תפארת is the חולם. What a tremendous revelation. והיא האחרונה בלי ניקוד, היא המלכות. So why the last letter doesn't have נקודות below that? Because it's מלכות. A of מלכות doesn't need נקודה. שאין בה נקודה. והיא מקבלת לכולם. And this receive from all of them. This is my friend from the Gra הקדוש, גאון מווילנה. Thank you so much. I would love to continue more, but I think that's good enough for everybody.